That means they're not going to get to play what got them here. They're now going to have to bring up something a little bit new.
So Lee Sin taken out there. Not going to be seeing any more of him today, at least in the 1v1s. Kennen taken out, standard ban for 1v1. Nunu taken out, another standard. And wouldn't surprise me to see Draven go in as well.
That means there's a fair bit left, though. We've seen Quinn banned in almost all of these.
Yeah.
And there was a Quinn played in one of the play-in matches that happened before the 1v1s even started getting broadcasted that I believe we have VODs available for. But that's really a potent choice as well. So this last ban, choice you got to think about a little bit.
I want to see a Red Elixir Gragas. That'd be dangerous.
It'd be awesome.
I'm not gonna lie, I'd be excited to see that as well. That would be fantastic.
Huge. You just drunken rage and dive into the fight.
People don't realize how much AD Gragas gets out of this W.
Yeah.
And then you get the 1% crit rune and actually crit a person, and they just disappear.
Belly.
Where did that come from?
So there we go. Annie was the final ban, another one that we've been seeing pretty regularly banned, all pick tier so far in the All-Star Weekend. But what are they gonna go for?
I cannot even begin to guess.
They have over 100 choices.
Yeah. Well, they have 106 left.
Yeah.
So one of those 106.
I think you're 100% right. I think you're 100% right on your prediction there, Jack. But
play it safe.
We'll have to see.
Still taking their time that neither of them are clicking in.
Yeah, what's going on here?
They are just waiting this one out.
Maybe they're thinking that if
you're
they
not
pick
gonna
something,
pick, I'm not gonna pick.
Like they're trying to gouge the crowd reaction if they're picking something they're famous for. So one of them, because these guys would know each other very, very well. I'm just wondering.
Wow, could we bring the Sheriffs back?
Oh no, Caitlyn was devastating from what we've seen.
Yeah.
At least when Diamond Proc is playing it, and these guys as mid laners might even have higher laning mechanics than the junglers. So.
Oh, let's see Caitlyn in there for Toys Messiah. He's leaving things up. Twisted Fate Messiah, he's done that on purpose. He wanted to get this reaction from the crowd. I'm not
hometown
sure if he's
boost.
Actually going to play it, though.
Hometown boost right there. He does have 8 seconds to lock in. He has not chosen to do it, though. Oh, my God, we're going to get the real Sheriff of mid lane.
Nice.
Second Caitlyn matchup.
Toys was hanging on Smite there. I'm guessing that he actually changed at the end. Slight. Like, I'm going to get that one minion. That could be the one. Get to 99 Smite. I've won it. But that's going to be changed out. So it's going to be a Caitlyn mirror matchup, which we have seen before. Jungle semifinals.
Yeah.
Where
don't take trap first.
Don't take trap first. Is I think the general idea that we've come with.
Toys has Smite.
He does have Smite. He kept it.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's going to come down to the farming battle. Both at 99, he's like, what up, Smite? I win the game.
The element of surprise, Ignite.
That's ridiculous, as far as I can tell.
Oh,
10
man.
Extra. I wonder if you brought the Smite Master. I didn't get a chance to check because I didn't lock it until so long.
Pretty symmetrical on both sides besides the summoners as we begin the mid lane matchup. China's LPL's Messiah versus Garena All-Stars Toys.
I have no idea what to expect here. Toys coming in with Smite has really thrown me off. And it's both cop Caitlyn's as well, we should mention.
It switched over to Messiah and I was like, did Caitlyn just say welcome to the magma chamber? So here we are, we see Messiah put himself out. They know they're not doing any tricky stuff in the brush. And they begin to push both lanes. Peacemaker's out.
Yeah, and unlike the last time we saw this between Troll and Diamond Prox, they both started with the Q instead of one guy putting in traps, the other one saying, what are you doing that for? Just running past him and shooting him.
There's another Peacemaker coming out. This I'm not connecting, and Messiah has now missed both of his Peacemakers that he's thrown into things, but they're doing a good job of keeping up with the farm here. Messiah, when he hits this one, has gone all the way as we are going to see the Ignite coming down onto Toys. Barrier going to be used. Peacemaker does land. That's good damage from Messiah. No kill yet, though.
It's one thing that is weird is, are you pressured to pop the pot at the same time? Toys was after that, and Messiah was like, no, ignite, negate the pot and attack.
I think you absolutely are, at least for the red elixir.
Yeah.
That was a 1% crit.
Wow, and that's why a 1% crit can actually be, I think in 1v1, even more so, that you know, just that one time that you get lucky.
So you're
win
saying they have a chance.
It's around 1%. It's not a big chance, Riv, but it is there.
Well, they both have the same chance.
Oh,
so we'll
gosh.
See if Toys gets it equalized here.
There we go. Hopefully it's one of the early 100 shots that he's going to put out here, or 99, if you will. Level two for each of them. Still potions just running out of Messiah there. He goes in with the caliber net.
Oh, turret is trapped.
He may have a headshot to come up. Messiah's four shots off near the turret. They're going to be very close on this one. 100 HP each. Toys going back as Messiah stays in the lane.
I think he realized he was going to lose that one. That was a great Piltover Peacemaker dodge, and Messiah hadn't used barrier yet. So it would have been over if he didn't decide to go back. Actually, Messiah, I feel like, won the Rune Mastery Wars here. He has all armor. He didn't go, I'll come back to it. I feel like there was a way. I didn't remember all the runes. We'll get there.
Well, we are seeing Messiah going back home. Cloth armor and pots for toys. Let's see what he has got to do with this one. He's brought himself back level now with the CS since Messiah did go home. And that barrier is up. I never thought I'd be saying this in a Caitlyn mirror matchup, but Smite is also available for Caitlyn right now.
And he's, I don't think he's really maybe used it once or twice here. He's using it for that extraneous circumstance.
Yeah, I can't tell, but
got to do it when it's under the turret. Oh, Smite got it.
I feel like he should just smite the cannon minions to shove faster, but he's just smiting random minions just for fun. Is it giving him a gold edge? He's about like 100 gold up, 6 minion kills plus the extra smite stuff. So if he doesn't die, Toys is technically winning this.
And that is the whole strategy behind that good old smite pick up there, as Messiah is going to go in aggressive here on towards Toys. There's the net and the Peacemakers being exchanged as well. And with that wave down, 22 to 18 is how it stands in the farm.
And we can see the AD carries are allowing the players to put more pressure back onto the turrets, as we haven't seen through any of the first games. We saw more aggression here from Messiah. Toys up a bit in health though.
And I'm trying to apply logic where logic probably doesn't exist here. But if he has the Smite Mastery, which he probably doesn't even have, every like 3.5 smites would mean another health potion. As far as actually trying to farm out and just get more kills, that probably doesn't matter though.
Messiah working the headshots, working the positioning of Toys, and just keeping them right off of UCS there to even it up now, 4 minutes in. I'm liking what we're seeing.
Totally fair here, except the barrier's gonna be up quickly for Toys, but the Ignite's gonna be up quickly for Messiah. So the fact that he kind of just burned it willy-nilly before, little bit interesting choice. Well, he had it for the 5 AD mastery as well, so he's had actually 5 AD up on Toys this whole time.
Well, he did it right after Toys popped that pot, so
yeah.
Yeah, exactly. And with that wave coming down, it should be level once again after this next wave gets cleared out here by Toys, or not, as he misses one and proves me wrong and misses two.
That wasn't good. I mean, we thought it was going to stay even, but has to shop after that too. Uh-oh.
Oh, he's actually going to be coming in here, though, with that Doran's Blade. So a bit of extra added in now for Toys, but Messiah just got that full wave, and Toys needs to make sure they doesn't miss any this time around.
He's going to miss one.
Two.
Oh,
I thought he got the shot off. So 35 to 32. Should see Messiah coming back out here. And with that Ignite, throwing that Ignite on, Toys is going to have to run. That Ace in the Hole could be a lot more impactful if they can get a barrier out in the next fight here.
Yeah, I mean, the items are straight, pretty much even. I can't tell. Let me see. Who has more health potions? Messiah has 3 more health potions than Toys, so if they actually do get into some extended trading, Toys is just going to have to go back to base.
There is the smite again, this time on towards the cannon minion. So definitely using that to good effect here. Exchange. We are going to see the net coming out. Messiah may decide to go aggressive, and it is level 6, so both players now having that Ace in the Hole available.
And these minion kills are getting increasingly important. Every time I see one go down, I just kind of, that hurts him in the end. And it's also interesting how Messiah is going in with his E, whereas Choice is going out. So Choice is actually always getting the damage out of his 90 caliber net. Even though it's just 80 magic damage, it still should technically be stacking up a bit.
It has to be noted that Messiah is dictating what Toys is doing. He has been on the aggression since the first second of this match.
Yeah, especially just, he ignited them as soon as he saw him.
Yeah.
Element of surprise.
Element of surprise. And there it is again! It's so surprising!
Peacemaker goes in as well after the ignite.
I didn't know that would happen! Wow!
I thought I was missing something there. But we got an extra man on the round, Magma Chamber somewhere coming in for a sneaky gang on the side. But 49 to 39, and talking about those minions, they are starting to increase. And if it carries on like this, there's not been a massively clear winner when it comes to fights.
Toys trying to get himself back into this. We'll have to see what the buy is for Messiah. His barrier's still up. Toys, like you said, still with Smite. And It has, I guess Messiah knows he can be aggressive for that reason. He's like, you're gonna bring a useless summoner spell for your lane. I'm gonna just aggress you out.
Just better stats, really, Messiah has. He brought more armor to the table, so he's taking less damage from choice hits. Every time he uses Ignite, he's got more AD.
Oh.
And then the Ignite on top of it is just exacerbating the situation.
And you can see he's feeling it. He's missing free CS there in the middle. Gets a good Peacemaker down. He's gonna be able to clear the rest of this wave, but it's going to be in the favor of Messiah still. He's looking to be five minions up, and Doran's up as well to the red elixir of toys.
Elixir though. Made with a selling sign, and this one is toys. We're gonna go in there. Decent damage done. And I wonder if it's gonna get to the point where they start using the ace in the hole just to force them out.
Maybe a little bit. They're both stacking so many health potions though that they'd almost want to save it for a kill, and this does seem increasingly like a battle for farm, which Messiah's winning by about a wave.
Playing a lot more passive every time that Ignite is down. Playing it safe with the Caliber Net and getting the combo off very nicely.
Yeah, that was really nicely done from Messiah there off to the side. And actually running low on mana. It looks like he's actually going to be handed back home once again.
And I wonder if Toys is going to be able to deny any minion kill here. He should shove this as quickly as possible. But look how fast. Like if Messiah actually makes it back to this wave before he loses a minion, then it basically puts the pressure on Toys to have to kill. And yeah, he made it all the way back to base without missing a single creep.
And it's going to attack that one, so he has the method to the madness of last hitting under the turret all to himself. That's a full wave for him, and Toys is going to have to back here, seeing more armor on Messiah with that Doran's. He's trying to catch up.
Still falling a bit behind, and another thing Toys did is he popped a red elixir too, so he's got a bit of a window where he's trying to get the shove on.
Yeah.
Maybe it's time that Toys just tries to go for some turret damage, because as they stack up, it's not like the turrets are that healthy. Both of these guys are sitting at 1550 max health on the turret. There's only 1,000 health left on Messiah's turret, so if he were to go back there and, you know, want to last hit all his minions at turret, if somehow Toys could outshove the other Messiah, then he could actually get a few hits on the turret. But aside from that, I feel like he's going to lose the CS battle.
Further we go on here as well, the more traps are getting put down, and that always makes it that bit more dangerous. You step on one, it's a Peacemaker, and definitely follow-ups from that. So they both need to be a little bit careful about that. And you can see it's like,
yeah, it's a bit of a minefield right there. And I'd personally be getting a little bit confused. Sure, they're color-coded, but I would definitely make at least one slip-up running through these things.
See what they can decide to do. Looks like Toys has been holding the smite for when he pushes Messiah out of the lane to get the lane push of the turret faster, because he doesn't use it every time it's up.
Yeah, I think that's what's happening. Or he's just using it on the cannons every time they come, which is every third wave.
Mm-hmm.
Unless they've changed it around for Magma Chamber, I'm not sure. That might be helping, and that's like the extra 50 damage he has on the turret, but based on just the timing that Messiah's going back, this is Toys' time to farm. He needs to use the smite on this wave and get as fast as possible.
Well, let's see if he does it. Beastmaker gonna go through. He's gonna be smiting down, so he is gonna push this one straight onto the turret, but in the end, Messiah is back just in time, and he's gonna be taking them back in as we are gonna see the Ignite use onto Toys. There is the barrier. He's gonna go for the turret kill here.
Kill.
He's sticking around. He's going
for
that turret. He's managed to dodge
a Beastmaker.
He's gonna win it. Toys takes down the turret as Messiah backs away. And look at the face of Messiah there. He can't believe what just happened.
If he didn't smite that minion. No, I'm just kidding. That was amazing.
I think
play.
You're right. That was very close.
Yeah, because
there was one minion left.
It pushed faster. It pushed the wave faster there. It accumulatively, the damage on the turret, because he got an extra couple shots earlier because of smite. The fact that he didn't die to Ignite, the smite worked.
Yeah. Okay. It did.
Yeah.